Welcome to yet another special edition of Lockdown Questions. And today joining us on the broadcast are two guests, Dr. Pinky Goswami and also senior psychiatrist Yusuf Maschizwala. But for the moment, quickly going across to Dr. Goswami. Dr. Goswami, thank you for speaking to us this afternoon. And our callers will be dialing in soon. But, you know, let's just begin with the basic question of how people are trying to keep their mental health in check right now, given the fact that everyone has been placed under a lockdown for the past so many days. So certainly running out of things to do to keep themselves busy, and that certainly catches up on a person's mental health. So what would your suggestion be to everyone?
First of all, that each and every one of us are in the same situation is quite positive, because it's not that only one of us, it's all of us in the same situation. And therefore, that itself should keep us very positive. To remain positive is extremely essential at this moment. To do so, I would suggest mindfulness. Mindfulness is practicing to be in the present situation. It's very important to be in the present situation. And India is doing very well when it comes to the international other countries. Therefore, I would suggest, please practice mindfulness, stay in present, be happy. Be happy that you are in a moment where all of us are doing good. We as a country are doing very good. And keeping positive means our immunity level will be very high. And therefore, it'll help us to fight against this coronavirus. And second thing, yes, we are running out of activities. But the point is, humans are known to be the most adaptive species. Therefore, initially, we might have found difficulty in adjusting to a lockdown routine. But I'm sure once the lockdown opens up and we have to go back to our normal routine, that equally will take a toll on us. So why not just feel very good about this moment and remember Shah Rukh Khan's movie, Kal Ho Na Ho. Let's enjoy the moment now.
Oh, yes, of course. Brilliant piece of advice there, Dr. Goswami. But, you know, several people have also been saying that for how long can they really go ahead, try new activities, engage themselves in something new? Because beyond a point, it all gets monotonous, right? Trying a new thing every day also, for how long can someone be at it? So in that sense, what would your piece of advice be? How should one go about maintaining a timetable, if at all? What should they do really to keep switching from one activity to the other?
First of all, why are we even trying it? We must live it. Instead of trying, when we try, it's an effort. But when we live it, then it becomes a part of our life. So let's think that we are living a life, practice a timetable, because we humans are very used to a timetable. So when we have a timetable with the ticking of the clock, we know what exactly we are supposed to do at that part of time. Like when we are in corporates or in schools or in universities, we all have a timetable. And the meaning of this timetable is that we are utilizing each moment productively. So even at home, if we maintain our timetable, it will not only help us to be productive, but also it helps us to pass our time well. For example, if we get up at 8 or 7:30, have our tea at 8, take a bath at some time, and then do some official online work or get back to your lunchtime, it helps us if we keep ourselves timed, because time helps in living the moment. So I would suggest that all of us should keep our timetable, which we need to follow it.
And Dr. Goswami, what would your suggestion to parents be? Because, you know, even children are having to stay at home. They're now attending classes, e-classes. They're attending classes online. But young children specifically have several questions coming in. And as for explanation of a coronavirus itself is a big challenge for the parents. So how should parents go about this really?
First of all, in a normal time, parents are not able to give that much time to children today, because most parents, both the parents, have been working. And therefore, this is the time when we should sit, let them question. The questioning mind is always appreciated. Let them question whatever they want to question, they should question. And parents should keep themselves well informed about explaining to them how to keep themselves patient during this lockdown phase and how to keep themselves safe, they will be coming up with questions. And mostly all of us are in a questionable state because we ourselves do not have many information. Sometimes informations are not authentic, but we are trying to get information. For now, it will be important if we just tell our children that we need to keep ourselves neat, hygienic, wear mask if at all anybody is going out, not to move out at all, and keep yourself productively involved in something or the other. Children, of course, are doing a good job because they are happy connecting, because this generation is always on the virtual world. But yes, the teenage, I'm getting a lot of calls from teenagers and teenagers' parents, because suddenly parents are home and they are kind of really on the children from morning till night. They're not getting any space. I myself have a teenage children at home, and I feel that suddenly all of us are becoming, kind of chokidars, or I should say watchmen over them. We should give them space. Yeah. Suddenly, if we have time, does not mean that we intrude in their private spaces. We need to give some space to our teenagers.
Certainly. So all of us must look at the positives and look at this as an opportunity to spend more time with our loved ones. So looking at the positive certainly is going to be of help.
Absolutely.
But we have a first caller, Chirag. Chirag calling us from Mumbai. Dr. Goswami has a question for you. Thanks for calling us, Chirag.
Yes.
Go ahead.
Yeah, hi. Good afternoon, madam.
Good afternoon, Chirag. Tell me.
Yeah. My actually question is, as long as, this lockdown and everything is concerned, we are sitting home and we have locked ourselves down, but that is actually a prevention. But, we don't have a cure so far. But I've been watching Republic TV since it started. So the other day, Dr. Naresh Trehan was there on the video, and he said the virus dies at 50 degrees Celsius in 15 minutes. That is what his research is. And we can't reach that temperature naturally. But, during these microorganisms, we deal with this stress, that treatment. This is that fire. Logically, if you think that fire can increase the temperature to much more than 1200 degrees Celsius also, but the people sitting around the fire will surely experience the temperature of more than 50 degrees Celsius. And I believe that it's worth a try, that we try with 4 COVID patients who are active, who are not that clinically unwell. And we can try with 4 COVID patients and who are willing to take part in this. And once they are cured, we can test them after the treatment is done, after that Homa Agni Hotra is performed. And once they are okay, this is a simple treatment which everybody can do in their respective houses. And I'm sure if it works, the temperature will go out logically to 50 degrees Celsius and above. And being there for 15 to 20 minutes, I don't think it's going to be a pain for anyone. And it is also scientifically proven by researchers in Pune that the protein cover, which is there on the virus now, that is killed with that thing. I can share that PDF. I've already done that in the past, but I think, everyone is... Hello?
Yeah, hearing. I'm sure this is a lockdown brainwave that's coming to Chirag. That's nice. I'm sure most of our viewers are able to hear your suggestion. That is a good suggestion. I really don't know how well will it work. But yes, I must say that I appreciate your efforts in getting this up on Republic.
All right. So Chirag is an idea. Of course, everyone is doing their research as well. And that brings another question to my mind, Dr. Goswami. Too much of information and this barrage of information on COVID-19, everyone is on their devices, on their gadgets, updating themselves with what's going on. Do you think that can also be extremely toxic and people really need to break away from the same?
Yes, very much. Too much information are leading to excess anxiety in people. People who already are in anxiety or they are newly getting into this anxiety problems. It is suggested from the mental health world that we need not have information overload. It is not important because it is only going to make us anxious. All that we can do right now is keep ourselves safe. Information is only going to create anxiety. Anxiety is going to affect our immunity system. I have been putting up to people that, our WBC cells generally help us to fight the virus. But if we are anxiety, if you're anxiety prone or anxiety, we are having anxiety, this impacts our WBC, which will definitely lower our immunity, will make us more susceptible to the virus. So it will be very important to keep our anxiety low. But the point is, information will definitely, excessive information will definitely lead to more anxiety. So I would really request people not to overload themselves with information.
All right, all right. We have another caller calling us from Haryana. This is Vatsala. Vatsala has a question for Dr. Goswami. Go ahead, Vatsala.
Okay, hi. I'm suffering from severe stress since the lockdown, and I'm having borderline personality disorder. And okay. The lack of medicines, the lockdown, and my pets are in Delhi. And I'm constantly worried about my, all this over, you know, overwhelming amount of information on television. Everything is adding to my stress. So I don't know how to cope up with that.
Most importantly, as I have just noted it out, please do not, if it is causing you anxiety and you're already a stress-prone person, you should not get into receiving a lot of information. It's good enough if you are staying safe inside the house. It is really requested that you should not get into this information seeking right now. And secondly, regarding your psychiatric treatment, most of the hospitals are there available for your help if you need any psychiatric treatment. Plus, we have the online, the psychological counseling is going on almost in all cities. We are trying to reach out through radio, through TV, and also through our phone lines. So you can definitely get your help. You can take my number as well. You can reach me out whenever you want to. We all as a team are trying to reach out to
all
each
right.
and every
we
person
also
at
have...
the time.
Yes. Take care of yourself, Vatsala, and I hope that addresses your concern. We also have Yusuf Macheswala, a senior psychiatrist, joining us from Mumbai. I appreciate you speaking to us, sir. Self and Dr. Goswami were just talking about how over-information on COVID-19 is also getting people, pushing them rather into anxiety. What would your suggestion be? How do people strike the balance out? Because everyone wants to know everything that's going around this pandemic, but yet it's important to break away from the same.
Yeah, so again and again, repeatedly, please don't see the same message. That is what news, that is what is happening. You go on any channel, it's the same thing. Once in the morning, you take the information, whatever relevant information you want about the disease, about any new treatment if available for the preventive measures. And when, you know, what the government has given us for their inspection, our state government, our PMC, our central government, take that information. There are officials, like the Arogya Setu and these things are there on which you get most relevant information. Our mind is, if something is, repeatedly bashed into our brain, then you start, believing in those symptoms. You start feeling those symptoms. So that is what is happening. I am sitting in my consulting chamber in Baikala. Only reason because too many people are not able to solve their problem just only on the WhatsApp and on the phone. Some people need to come, some people need to share out. And some people require the required medications. And obviously, end of the day, they are in their house, the TV is in their hand, the remote is in their hand. Or many other channels are helping out in many, many different ways, trying to divert the mind also, not just related to this. There are very positive things also. People have spoken about the earlier such infections. Yeah, and how we have come out of it and how, end of the day, these things stay. End of the day, these things are going to improve our capacity, our immunity power. But today is a time when whatever best care you can, you take care of yourself, physically, of course, and then in the mental condition, because we saw how desperation happened. And everybody doesn't have, all the things, all the facilities in the house. If I go in my Wadala area and all where people are coming to me, they are all in a ghetto population. They are all, in one room, there are 10, 15 people staying. Where even social distancing is becoming a difficult. So, sir, these kind of situations also, we are trying to guide them in whatever way possible. any questions I would like
All
to
right.
take up.
In fact, Nikhil is calling us. He has a question for you, Dr. Macheswala. Go ahead, Nikhil. Thanks for calling. Your question, please.
Hello.
Hello, Nikhil Babu.
Go ahead, Nikhil. We can hear you. Go ahead.
Sitting at home.
Repeat what you said.
I am getting anxiety too by sitting at home.
Okay. Now you are feeling very kind of, you may be feeling lonely, though there may be people around. You are feeling scared. You are feeling anxious. What are the available things that you can do in your house? What are the good activities you can do? What are the ghar mein baithke exercises you can do? What are the ways you can interact with your family? So these are other simple ways, because many societies are not even allowing you to go down in the compound for a walk. What are the good ways of occupying your mind in your house is very important. Television, your mobile phone, your books, your reading, your simple breathing exercise. Now, so many people are showing us so many different exercises. Yesterday, I saw Sushmita Sen, she was showing us some wonderful exercise sitting at home. So, what are the good things that you can do? Tell me that. Nikhil, what exactly are you going through? What are your symptoms? You're worried, you're scared, you're anxious. This particular corona. The corona may be far away, but still you are kind of worrying about it all the time. As if corona tumhare baaj mein hai. Tell me.
Nikhil, that is the doctor's advice. Engage in as many activities. Look for more creative things that you can resort to. And of course, like all of us here have been telling ourselves, it's just a phase, it'll all get over, we're all in it together. So let's not forget that. Quickly going across to our next caller, Robin calling from Faridabad. The Dr. Goswami will be taking your question. Go ahead, Robin.
Hello, good afternoon.
Yes, Robin. Good afternoon, Robin.
Yeah, actually, it's kind of a my query or suggestion, whichever way you put it as, for you and for the TV anchor as well. Let me tell you, neither do I have any history of anxiety or the COVID-19 patient amongst my near and dear ones. But all I would suggest is, like the kind of a news which is being followed up in any of the TV channels per se. Like, for example, just COVID-19, and there was too much of it, which is creating unnecessarily mental anxiety. So all I would suggest, especially maybe you can market correctly, like just in case if you think I'm right. Like, news channels should follow up the other news also. For example, especially the international ones. I know. Like, in today's scenario, they have. But that is, I guess, one of the best way to keep the stress level low. Because, as I said, that's more of a suggestion than a query. I hope you endorse that.
So, yeah. Yes, Robin, for this, I would like to say that the news challenge. The news challenge. The news channel is for everybody. So you never know who will be watching the news channel at what time. So the news channel will be broadcasting all the news. So it is with us how much we want to watch and when do we want to switch it off. Let's put the finger on us and switch it off when we are over with the information. It is not like a cricket match. Most of us are telling y'all, it's not like a cricket match that we will be continuously knowing what the commentary should be. So it should be more on us, I think, Robin, when we need to switch off the TV rather than telling our TV people not to broadcast information, because we don't really know which person will be watching the TV at what time. So I would rather like to put the finger on our own self.
Very well said, Doctor. Very well said.
I believe Dr. Macheswala also wanted to add on. Yes, Doctor.
Yes.
First of all, what he said, the news channels are also diverting. I mean, it's not that it's COVID 24/7. They are showing us many other aspects. Of course, because today this is something which the world is being affected with. So information, whatever is coming related, has to be given. So that is the job of the channel. But even the channels, different kinds of interviews, like this interview with doctors or interviews with economists, so many other things are happening, you know, where we have been there were certain interviews with the media people, with the celebrities. So they kind of, give us some other aspects also, which is infotainment. You know, there is information and there is some entertainment. Yeah, and finally, Dr. Goswami, so wonderful, he said, what is in your hand? You decide how much of, relevant information you want.
I would also like to add, that our hunger for information is our hunger. It is our hunger. So we need to, satisfy our hunger. We should know when to have that button stopped, because that hunger for information are pushing us. We are continuously, people are going from one channel to other channel only in search of COVID information. So it is our hungry mind which is searching for information. If you want, you can control your mind. It is all in the mind.
And to add to the doctors, Robin, it is our responsibility to put out the information well in time, to keep you ahead at all times, like a doctor, like a police official, like anyone who is engaged in essential services right now. We certainly can't shrug away from that responsibility. So you should feel free to break away whenever you need to, but we need to keep doing our duty. We leave it at that. Next caller calling in from Bangalore, Chitran. Chitran, your question, please. Go ahead.
Yeah. Good afternoon, doctors. Hello.
Good afternoon.
I'm Chitra calling from Bangalore. Just my problem is, we are senior citizens only, myself and my husband. We are staying here in the house. I engage myself in walking in the house itself, doing small exercises, everything. I'm not carried away by this COVID virus and all. But whenever this lockdown violation is happening, I'm seeing the news in the TV, just my blood boils like anything. My BP shoot up at that time. Even if I take tablets and all, that's not helping me in any way. Even in my apartment itself, when people are breaking the rules and regulations, I get very much upset, and I started doing the cleaning work in the apartment. Then people start calling me, "Oh, this lady, she is always like this only." So then we try to correct the people, and they start laughing at us, and this gives me mental stress. And because of this lockdown, it's getting more and more. Otherwise, I'm perfectly all right. No problem at all. I just
Chitra, first of all,
household works, everything. When I see
Chitra, first of all,
VIPs, they break the rules and regulations of this lockdown, then I feel, why do they just can this poor people, and they are not doing any giving any punishment, severe punishment for this VIPs? Rules are made for others, not for the person who made it.
All right.
First of all, Chitra, all right. I appreciate...
Now, this is something like OCPD. Yeah. OCPD, why not? Like you have something called obsessive compulsive personality disorder. So this is something like that.
Doctor, here I would like to add, first of all, Chitra, I appreciate your efforts. But at the same time, hello, Chitra, can you hear me?
I cannot tolerate it. So she has to inform
Chitra.
Authorities.
Yes. Doctor, go ahead. She can hear you. Dr. Machiswala, we'll come to you
first
also. Dr. Goswami,
Chitra, first of all, I appreciate your efforts, but at the same time, one little suggestion for you here. You are very much cooperating with the lockdown given by the nation, but the point is, when you get your BP high, the lockdown in your system gets affected. So you have to understand that you cannot get your BP high. You can only tell them, you can inform the required people, you can inform police if somebody is breaking any lockdown kind of rules and regulations, but do not get your BP high on this, because that means your body lockdown will get affected. I mean, we are also required to keep our homeostasis, which we say the balance inside our body, at a balanced level. Therefore, it will be really appreciated if you do not get boiled up at these people, rather manage those and keep yourself calm. That will be very important for all of us. You are important for us.
Dr. Machiswala, quick word, 30 seconds, we're short of time. Go ahead.
About this, so basically she's a very perfectionist lady, like how we have some people. and she wants everything perfect in her house, outside her house, and she cannot tolerate it. Yeah, on one side, wonderful, such people are required in our society. But at what cost? Because it is now affecting her. She gets anxious, she gets restless. As she says, her adrenaline level shoots up. So basically, she will either have to have a balance, otherwise she needs to talk to some of us, and we can help her out in how to balance. We need such people. There are some people in our society who don't, and there are such wonderful people, really, really kind of, cannot. But it could be affecting her own health.
Yes. In fact, it's also a message for all those who are violating the lockdown. Please do not do it. Don't do it for everyone else around you, because people are in fact getting affected by the same. But we'll have to leave it at that, Dr. Goswami and Dr. Macheswala. Appreciate you joining us this afternoon, taking all of those questions. I hope all those concerns have been addressed well in time. Thank you for speaking to us.
Anybody needing any help in Mumbai, my team of psychiatrists are all there. We are all there.
We are all available on the phones.
Yes. Thank you.